Hello, everyone. Welcome. Thank you so much for tuning in and joining us. Welcome to this speaker series about Indigenous arts and storytelling. My name is Lindsay LaChance, and I am the Artistic Associate of Indigenous Theatre at the National Arts Centre, and I'm from an Algonquin Anishinaabe family. Today, I am so honoured and happy to be joined by Mohawk Algonquin Anishinaabe artist Simon Brakupe. Although we're not together in the same room today, we are both connecting and chatting over the airwaves of the unceded traditional and ancestral territories of the Algonquin Anishinaabe.
Kwe kwe. I'm an Anishinaabe Algonquin from Gitigan Zibi Anishinaabe, which is near Maniwaki, just north of Ottawa. As you recognized earlier, we are in Algonquin territory. So the traditional territory went from roughly Manitoba to Montreal and all the rivers that come into it. My father was from Gitigan Zibi, and my mother is Mohawk. Her mother is from, or was from, Six Nations. So I'm both Algonquin and Mohawk at the same time.
And do you feel like your cultural backgrounds, do they influence the kind of art that you make?
The simple answer is yes. Our art is an expression of who we are as people, as a person, as part of a family, community. And certainly having Algonquin ancestry has been beneficial to me as a human being. My idea as an artist is really tied up with who I am. You know, I think most artists have a difficulty answering that question because art is who we are. And from a very early part of my life, I really love to express myself through art. And I really enjoyed it intensely. Sometimes when I dream, I just see images coming down. It's like hundreds of them, thousands of them. There's no way I could possibly do them all. But that goes to say who I am. My spirit, my creative spirit is being expressed in a tidy way through my art.
And we were able to, at the National Arts Center, really feel connected and see a lot of your work specifically on the Kipnis Lantern last year for National Indigenous Peoples Days, as well as this year we will be showing your piece Sky Woman again on the Kipnis Lantern. We're so excited.
It's filling me with pride that the NAC is part of the reconciliation work that's going on in Canada, and I think it's an important part of it that not only people from Ottawa but from people from across Canada has an opportunity to see Indigenous performers, musicians, plays. The lantern, I love glass for one thing. And then having an opportunity to show my artwork there was really, really exciting for me.
Would you be able to tell us a little bit about the story or the teachings behind Sky Woman, which is the piece that we will be able to see of yours on the lantern this year?
My Mohawk grandmother, Sarah Patterson, told us the Sky Woman story when we were growing up. And I think learning that teachings at a young age kind of becomes part of you. And I think our spirit, it speaks to our spirit as a human being, but also as an artist. The story about the Sky Woman coming down from the sky world into this world that was dark, and a turtle coming up out of the water and the Sky Woman lighting on the back of the turtle brought down by birds and then the beaver and the muskrat bringing soil from the bottom of the ocean to put on the back of the turtle, and then the sky woman walking counterclockwise on the back of the turtle, creating the world as we know it. And for me, the image of the sky woman reminds us of that, those early days of creation. But also for me, as I've gotten older as an artist, I realized the sky woman is still here, because creation has not ended. You know, it's still part of the world that we live in. And you know, with global warming, I think the world changes over time. So the sky woman's work is never done, and the role that we play in creation is never done.
One of the many things I love about your artistic practice and the work that you do is that you do work a lot with your family and with your community. And I was wondering if you wanted to speak a little bit about the importance of working with your family and with your community as well.
Well, I think one thing that is central to, I think, all Indigenous thinking is what kind of world are we creating for our generations to come? You know, the seven generations, the children that are unborn yet. And so I think passing that on through my children and through the community is important. Putting Algonquin culture and Algonquin art throughout the city is one way to communicate that we haven't disappeared. We're still here, that people can enjoy Algonquin art, and it offers a bridge between the two cultures, particularly, I think, in the city of Ottawa. So one of the projects at Pimbisi Station involved what we're calling the Algonquin canoe, Mabawi, together. And we know that the canoe can't be paddled by just one person. It has to be many people paddle and guide the canoe. And so I was able, with my daughters, to go to Algonquin communities on the Ontario side and Quebec, and we ran workshops where Algonquins from age 6 to over 80 painted or their own paddle. I learned a lot from Algonquins. They were saying, you know, like the paddle itself, they were saying that the original canoe was inspired by the beaver, that in the past Algonquins did not have canoes. But when you harvesting and take the fur off a beaver, you look inside the chest cavity and you see the ribs like a canoe. So the beaver inspired the first canoe, and the beaver tail inspired the first paddles. Each paddle is its own history, has its own story. I like to talk about the importance of land. The land is our teacher. That's expressed through all the artwork that's in the Algonquin canoe.
I guess finally, because we are building up to National Indigenous Peoples Day, what exactly does celebrating National Indigenous Peoples Day mean to you? Where would you normally find yourself if unfortunately all the powwows and weren't canceled this season? But what is it that your family and your community normally do on to celebrate and honor National Indigenous Peoples Day?
Well, normally we volunteer at the Summer Solstice Indigenous Festival, and it's right around, you know, June 21st. And so on that day, we're often involved with schools. We're able to reach out to young students. I think that's important because when you're young, those memories have an impact on you. And the opportunity to engage with Indigenous artists and dancers and creative people, I think is a tremendous bridge between the Indigenous culture and people that live here in Ottawa. And then often we have art exhibits. Of course, we're eating. The powwow is on. But this year, everything's virtual. I've got a project that I'm working on, which is called Paint Night with Simon Brockepay. And I'm doing an Algonquin moose, a red Algonquin moose. So people can sit in their home and I'll go through the whole process and explain and tell stories about these famous moose stories from the past.
It's great that there's still something that you can offer and give out to the community. I'm going to sign up for the paint night now. Well, I just want to say, Miigwech, thank you so much for taking the time to chat today. And we're also so excited and honored to have Sky Woman and your work up on the lantern. And so we hope that folks in and around the Ottawa area will be able to check it out this month, this June, leading up to National Indigenous Peoples Day. Miigwech, Simon.
Miigwech, thank you. Good to speak to you.
Me too.